Have a blessed day mga ka-mathers sa mga math-enthusiast and resilient students. Muli, ako inyong guro sa mathematics, Sir John Olorbida. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe my channel para updated kayo sa mga video lessons ko in Learning Mathematics 6. Our topic today is about visualizing and describing solid figures. Are you ready to learn this topic? So sit properly and enjoy my video. But before that, let us take a short review about the different figures in geometry. Can you name this figure? And yes, this is what we call that. How about this? Okay, this is ray. Next, can you name this figure? Meron tayong dalawang dot connected by a line. So that is what do we call line segment. Good job, kids! And this figure, what is this? Yes, that is a trapezoid. And this is what do we call? Yes, it is a triangle, but to be exact, it is called as equilateral triangle. And the last figure, what do we call to that figure? And that is the parallelogram. Congratulations, great job, each and everyone. Mga ka-mathers, we are done with the real numbers, including fractions, decimals, and integers. So today, we are going to tackle about geometry. But before that, what is geometry? Geometry is a branch of mathematics that studies the size, shapes, positions, angles, and dimensions of things. It started with the dot. Yan ang simula ng geometry. Then, we came up with the line segment. May dalawang dot na pinag-connect na form ang line segment. Then, na-form ang tinatawag nating ray, pinagpatuloy natin yung line segment. And kapag na-form may line segment at wala na siyang katapusan, nabuo na ang lines. At after na mabuo ang line, saka ang ray, ayan, meron na tayong tinawag na acute angle, right angle, obtuse angle, straight angle, reflex angle, and full rotation angle. Afterwards, nabuo na mga plane figures or mga closed figure. Then, nabuo ang solid figures na tinatawag na three-dimensional figures. And those are our lesson for the day, the solid figures. But before that, let us differentiate first plane figures from solid figures. So here are the plane figures, the rectangle, circle, triangle, oval, parallelogram, trapezium, pentagon, hexagon, diamond, right triangle, heptagon, octagon, decagon, dodecagon, and square are called plane figures. While the rectangular prism, sphere, cone, cylinder, pyramid, cube, triangular prism are called solid figures. Plane figures are flat, two-dimensional, or 2D shape. A plane figure can be made of straight lines, curved lines, or both straight and curved lines, and have no thickness. While the solid figures are three-dimensional or 3D figures that have length, height, width, and take up space. Yan ang pagkakaiba nung dalawa. Yung isa flat, or 2D, yung isa, three-dimensional na meron ng space sa loob. Here are the dimensions of solid figures. Meron tayong tinatawag na length, may width, and may height. And here are the parts of the solid figure. Na number one is face, flat surface at disa of solid figure. So, yung pinakang harapan o pinakang mukha ng isang solid figures. Base, face on which the figure rests, edge, line segment where two faces meet, and vertex, point where two or more faces or edges meet. So, ang edges, ito, yung pinakang edge niya. And the vertex, ito, pinakang kanto, pinakang corner ng bawat solid figures. Have you been to Fantasy World at Lemery, Batangas? Here you can see this, what do we call the castle, the undone or unfinished castle ng mga Japanese na ngayon ay it was managed by the homeowners diyan sa Lemery, Batangas. At dito sa Fantasy World, you can see different solid figures. Can you name some solid figures na makikita natin dito sa Fantasy World? Okay. So, what solid figure is in the picture? Yes, this is a cube. And this side is what do we call the net of the cube. Cube is a solid three-dimensional figure which has 6 square faces, 8 vertices, and 12 edges. So, square faces, 6. 6 ang kanyang harapan. So, 1, 2, yun nasa likod, 3, 4, 5, and nasa taas ang pang 6. So, those are the faces of the cube. Ang 8 vertices, pinakang sulok, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So, those are the 8 vertices. And 12 edges, pag dinrawing natin yan, ayan, 1, 2, 3, 4, ang nasa top, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Yan yung edges ng cube. How about this shape or this solid figure? This is what do we call rectangular prism. And this is the net of the rectangular prism. Rectangular prism is a 3D solid shape that has 6 rectangular faces in which all the pairs of opposite faces are congruent. It has 6 faces, 12 edges, and 8 vertices. So, same sila ng cube. May 8 vertices sila bawat sulok na yan. Same din ang kanilang faces, same ang kanilang edges. Okay, so maliwanag na ang rectangular prism. Next, this is what do we call the triangular prism. Triangular prism is a 3D shape with 2 identical bases in the shape of a triangle connected by 3 rectangular faces. The rectangular faces are referred to as the lateral faces while the triangular faces are called the bases. So, eto meron tayong 3 rectangle. Rectangle 1, rectangle 2, rectangle 3, and triangle 1, and triangle 2. And kapag nabuo na yung net na yan, we can form the triangular prism. And next is pyramid. Yes, a pyramid is also a three-dimensional 3D shape. It has a polygon base and flat triangular sides that join at a common point called the apex. So, ito yung kanyang tinatawag na apex. We often think of a famous pyramids in Egypt when the word pyramid is mentioned. So, these are the nets of pyramid. Pwede kasi iganyan ang mga nets ng pyramid. Pag inayos natin sila, we can form pyramid. At ang pyramid, kung makikita natin, ito yung tinatawag na base. Ang base ng pyramid natin sa example na to ay square. So, this is a square pyramid. So, yung base niya ay polygon. Pwede siya maging triangle, square, rectangle, or heptagon, pentagon. And this is the face. So, kung ang ating base ay square, so ang face natin ay 4. 4 faces ang ating pyramid. There are many kinds of pyramid. Based on the shape of the base of the pyramid is classified as triangular pyramid. So, let us take a look. Ang base natin dito sa example na to ay triangle. So, triangular pyramid siya. Kapag triangular pyramid, ang face niya ay 3. Then, square pyramid. Look at the base. Ayan, square siya ang base kaya siya tinawag na square pyramid. So, square pyramid, ang magiging face niya ay 4 na faces. Rectangular pyramid, look at the base. It's shaped rectangle, so it was called rectangular pyramid. Next is pentagonal pyramid because the base is pentagon. So, kapag siya ay hexagon, hexagonal pyramid. Pag heptagon, heptagonal pyramid. Octagon, octagonal pyramid. So, those are the different kinds of pyramid. Another solid figure is what do we call the cone. A cone is a 3D shape consisting of a circular base and one continuous curved surface tapering to a point or the apex above the center of the circular base. So, meron tayong tinatawag na base at ang base niya ay circular. Ang pagkaiba nito sa pyramid, so, ang base niya ay circle at syempre, pa ang curve ang kanyang surface, hindi flat, curved surface siya. At syempre, meron din siyang apex na tinatawag o yung vertex kung saan nag-meet ang mga angles. Then next is cylinder. A cylinder is a three-dimensional solid that holds two parallel bases joined by a curved surface at a fixed distance. These bases are normally circular in shape, like circle, and the center of two bases are joined by a line segment which is called the axis. So, ito yung una natin, yung net of cylinder. So, ang cylinder, meron tayong parallel sides. Ito yung dalawang parallel side. Curved din ang kanyang sides. At 2 ang kanyang circular base. Yun ang pagkakaiba ng cylinder sa cone. Sa cone, may apex and 1 circular base. Ang ating cylinder ay 2 circular bases. Last example is what do we call the sphere. A sphere is symmetrical, round in shape. It is a three-dimensional solid that has all its surface points at equal distances from the center. It has surface area and volume based on its radius. It does not have any faces, corners, or edges. So, wala siyang face, walang corners, walang edges kasi nga siya ay symmetrical round shape. And this is the net of the sphere. And these are the examples of a real life solid figures. There are examples of cubes, cylinders, spheres, prism or rectangular prism, triangular prism, pyramids, and cones. So, diyan sa bahay nyo, marami diyan mga different solid figures na kinakailangan ma-appreciate ng bawat isa. And that's all for today. How well do you understand the lesson? Type 4 sa ating comment section if you can do it by yourself and teach it to others. 3 if you understand and can do it by yourself. 2 if you almost there but need more practice. And 1 if you don't understand Yet, I hope na masasagutan nyo na ang mga written works at magagawa ang mga performance tasks na pinagagawa sa inyo ng inyong guro. And thanks for watching mga ka-mathers, ang mga math enthusiasts and resilient students. Goodbye for now and see you again for our next educational video vlog. Again, I am your teacher, Sir Johnny Olorbida. Keep safe everyone and God bless all of you. Bye!